where should I sit? I'll sit here.
Who has good knees?
Who has good knees?
No, mine are also.
Everybody's a god.
Yeah. All of you, we're delighted that you could join us this evening. You may know that the Rolling Next Sports Foundation has organized a number of successful events across India for the in squash. And now we're delighted to announce that Rolling Next Sports Foundation brings yet another very, very exciting sporting event. The Indian Premier Squash League 2018. It will be India's first international squash league and will take place right here at this beautiful and prestigious club, the CCI. This format turns an individual sport has been a way of your life. Tell us a little about your journey with fitness and the importance, you know, in the view of communicating it in a, like, you know, just being fit, you being fit, how do you keep up to that?
I think it's a tremendous asset in life to be fitter than not. Because it allows you to grapple with far greater challenges that may come your way. And I think the only way to have a sustained commitment to fitness, and I would even go as far as to say a lifetime commitment to fitness, is if you start young. So anybody who's played any kind of competitive sport at a young age, or has been part of a team sport, or any kind of sport, will value the returns that you get on the time you invest in fitness, and which is why I think I'm you know, one of the greatest things that's happening right now in the confines of this you know, these two squash courts and the area in between, is that we're seeing what will probably redefine the way squash is viewed as far as youngsters are concerned, and also leave with them not just maybe a competitive career, but the gift that they'll carry forward into their lives. I'm sure. You know, as you were chatting earlier, the knees and the impact on the knees of sport in younger years notwithstanding. I'm sure your squash, even if you play, I'm sure you play recreation, you're a master's player.
Yeah.
It has an incredible impact on how you feel about yourself.
Absolutely.
How you take on other challenges. And I think that's the beauty of sport. And fitness for the sake of fitness without sport can be done, but it's far more challenging. Because when you have, when you're chasing a goal, it just, it becomes that much easier. And commitment becomes easier. So any kind of fitness, when it's goal-oriented and can be tracked when you're chasing that set goal, is perhaps more inspiring than just fitness for the sake of fitness. And that's my two cents on it.
Wonderful. Many kids today struggle with balancing sport and academics. So what would be your advice to them?
I think the kids don't struggle, it's the parents. It's clearly, I mean, everybody wants their kids to be really, really bright, but at the same time, maybe they want their son to be Virat Kohli. And that pretty much sums it up. So if there's no cricket, which eats up all the sports money in this country, and maybe deservedly so for those who love cricket, but I think the entire orientation towards sport, and I'm being very general, I mean, I'm generalizing here, I know there are exceptions to this, but largely we see that either parents push their kids into academia in the hope that they will, you know, now be many other professionals along with the usual lawyer, doctor, engineer space. And if any kind of sport needs to be followed, it should be cricket, because cricket is where you get big returns. But for every successful Virat Kohli, there are millions and millions and millions others who perhaps haven't had that degree of success. So broadening the focus of Indian sport is I think very important. And you know, I thought I don't know if it's my place to say that, or even if I'm qualified, having not really been a squash player of any consequence. I think, and again, I could be wrong, and please feel free to correct me. One of the reasons perhaps we don't end up reaching where we should as a community, as a culture, is because we don't value sport enough as such. And we've seen our neighboring country produce some very fine squash players, so it's not a genetic disadvantage. In certain sports, yes, you know, Caucasian bodies are more predisposed to dominating certain sport, but we've had proof of our kind do so well. Again, I'm trying to compare apples and oranges here, but the point is, if we push students, young children into sport at an early age, it will yield eventually medals for India. You can't lament and say, oh, why don't we bring back Olympic medals, or why don't we dominate the sport globally, without actually having an impetus on grassroots inculcation of an interest in sport and fitness. Sorry, that was a very strong statement, but that's
so
my two cents.
Malaysia have shown really good interest that they will. As far as our Indian players are concerned, we have most of our top junior national champions in under 17, under 15, who have shown interest to play this league. Of course, this helps them to be part of the same team when they are playing, and their juniors and seniors together. So it helps our upcoming generations to learn from the men's.
Yes, my older daughter plays squash. I've got a 13 and a 3-year-old. So the 13 does play, but she's actually more involved and active.
Krishna, we have a question for you. For me?
I think all of us at any level, when we are going into a competitive atmosphere, there is an element of nerves. That's undoubtedly the truth. I've seen Roger Federer also say that before a big match, he is nervous. My view is that the more you play, the more matches you play, you learn how to deal with it. The nerves are never going to go away. It's just that you learn how to adapt with that feeling that you get in the summer, for that little feeling in your legs where you're a little weak. You just have to continue to push through it. And what are we nervous about? At the end of the day, is winning everything or being able to perform at your best more important? So my advice is, keep playing the matches, keep playing the tournaments, and you will slowly find that the nerves sort of dwindle away probably in the first 3-4 points.
Anybody else? Good questions.
Yes.
For you.
Well, the point is, as an actor, if a role excites you and if one of the things you do in that is play squash, I would love to do that. If I had to play the role of a squash player per se, I would love to do that, because I thought in some way, if you can, I think cinema has a very, very powerful impact on people. And if maybe seeing someone play a squash player well would encourage other people to take up squash, then I would definitely like to do that as well.
Just so that you know, that's my name.
Ah, okay.
You can come out.
Like a petting zoo.
You keep the door open only.
Yeah. I know. That's, we're just chatting
about questions. How much money was yours?
And then. I don't. Is that for me? I think
that's
for him.
For me, Rishad can answer that.
Yeah. My goal or my target when I started squash. I started squash at your age. My first match that I played here at CCI was in the handicap tournament, where I was given 8+ handicap. And in those days, you could only win after you won your serve, if you remember. I don't think you know that.
He doesn't know the American English.
Yeah. I mean, you just had to get 1 point for it. And I lost all 3 games without winning a point. That was my first match. And I just wanted to do better the next time. And I was able to win a game the following time. And then I started, after a while, I realized that I had some potential. Thanks to my family, they encouraged my sport, sent me off for training in various places. And as I developed as a squash player, 12, 13, then my target became national champion. So it doesn't happen overnight. You have to play the sport to then set realistic goals.
Akna, could you also share your journey so far? You know, how did you start squash and how did you reach so far?
So he has a better idea because he's been a national champion.
Yeah,
I have reached about top 8 in most of the categories, playing my juniors and men's. So yeah, I started at the same age at about 10 without any particular focus. Just started, loved the sport. Then started playing tournaments because back then there was not much academy setups and everything. So played few tournaments, got beaten up badly, and then started becoming better. And yeah, then was lucky to play the World Junior and Asian Juniors back in 2009. And then I played the men's and came up to top 8. So yeah, that's.
That's my nephew, and that one's my grandson. In the red shirt.
Okay.
Sure. Yeah.
So have you ever played sports?
I did. I tried. We'll quickly wrap this up and we'll.
Jay!
Okay,
yeah.
5 minutes, we'll quickly wrap this, okay?
क्या कहना चाहेंगे, कितना अच्छा लगता है जब इस तरह के इवेंट पर आप आते हैं और लोग प्रोत्साहित करते हैं, कितना अच्छा लगता है।
मेरा ये मानना है कि जितनी भी स्पोर्ट्स इवेंट्स हो सकती हैं हमारे देश में कम है, क्योंकि हमारे देश में इतनी सारी काबिलियत है, इतने सारे युवा हैं जो स्पोर्ट्स का हिस्सा बन सकते हैं जिन्हें मौके नहीं मिलते। और जब ऐसी इवेंट्स ऑर्गेनाइज होती हैं, इंडियन प्रीमियर स्क्वाश लीग ऑर्गेनाइज होती है, तो और लोगों को मौके मिलते हैं, एक तो स्पोर्ट्स से वाकिफ़ होने के और दो इन स्पोर्ट्स में हिस्सा लेने के लिए। मेरा ये मानना है कि जो अभिनव ने किया है यहाँ पर, ये एक बहुत बड़ी प्राप्ति है। इससे बहुत से बच्चों को, यंग एडल्ट्स को अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलेगी स्क्वाश के बारे में जानकारी प्राप्त करने की, और जो ऑलरेडी स्क्वाश प्लेयर्स हैं उन्हें मौका मिलेगा एक लेवल और एक स्टैंडर्ड के प्लेयर्स को परफॉर्म करते हुए देखने का। और मैं मानती हूँ कि इससे बड़ा प्रोत्साहन शायद किसी स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन को नहीं मिल सकता।
So it's very good to have a support from someone like Gul, who's come all the way to support squash. We definitely need more support in terms of some known people coming in, and hopefully she knows squash, so that's the whole reason she's here as well. So it's really good, and hopefully this event will be a different level of event in squash, and we'll try to make it as big as possible. Yeah.
फिलहाल जो हमारी आउटलुक है, जो हमारा नज़रिया है, पूरा क्रिकेट फोकस्ड है. और अगर पब्लिक का नज़रिया क्रिकेट फोकस रहेगा तो जो ब्रांड्स स्पोर्ट को फंड करते हैं उनका भी फोकस क्रिकेट की तरफ रहेगा. जब खेलने वाले लोग और जब पब्लिक दूसरे स्पोर्ट्स के बारे में जागरूक होगी तो जाहिर है ब्रांड्स भी उन स्पोर्ट्स में इन्वेस्ट करना चाहेंगे. तो अब जैसा कहते हैं, बॉल अब जनता के कोर्ट में है, पब्लिक के कोर्ट में है कि वो किस स्पोर्ट में रुचि दिखाना चाहते हैं, उसी स्पोर्ट को फिर ब्रांड्स के ज़रिए फंडिंग ज़रूर मिलेगी. पर पहल तो लोगों को खुद करनी पड़ेगी. ऐसा नहीं है कि कोई रेड कार्पेट लगा देगा, बोलेगा आइए अब आप ये गेम खेलिए. पर मैं बस इतना ही कहना चाहूँगी कि स्पोर्ट्स से जो भी लोग बचपन से जुड़े रहते हैं वो ज़िंदगी भर जुड़े रहते हैं, और उनको स्पोर्ट के साथ जुड़े रहने का बहुत बहुत फ़ायदा होता है. थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू.
Global Advertiser for innovative outdoor solutions.
Global as a company, it has never compromised on its service quality and commitment, and that is the reason our clients do keep on coming again and again to us for our service. The mission of the company is to rise on the graph of betterment for every campaign handled by us.
Sir, aapki film The Great Leader aa rahi hai, is par kuch roshni daliye.
रोशनी लीडर के साथ अपने आप चलती है, और हम क्या रोशनी डालेंगे उसके ऊपर. एक बहुत ही अच्छा विषय है इस फिल्म का, महिलाओं के प्रति जो है समाज में आजकल और कई गांवों में कई क्षेत्रों में अत्याचार होता है, उनको बढ़ावा नहीं दिया जाता. इसी के दायरे में ये कहानी बनी गई है. हीरो के पिता की भूमिका हम निभा रहे हैं, और हमारी पत्नी जया जो है वो हमारी पत्नी का रोल कर रहे हैं. तो ये एक हिंदी वर्जन है, तो मुझे बड़ा गर्व है कि मैं इस फिल्म में काम कर रहा हूँ.
द ग्रेट लीडर फिल्म के निर्माता दीपक सावंत हैं, जो पिछले 45 वर्षों से आपके मेकअप आर्टिस्ट हैं. लोग जानना चाहते हैं कि शूटिंग पर दीपक सावंत आपकी नज़र में मेकअप आर्टिस्ट होते हैं या निर्माता.
ये मेकअप आर्टिस्ट पहले मेकअप हमारा करते हैं, उसके बाद ये निर्देशक बन जाते हैं.
इस फिल्म की सफलता के लिए आप दर्शकों से क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
ग्रेट लीडर जो है वो जा करके देखें, और मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि आपको पसंद आएगी और आपको सराहनीय लगेगी.
दीपक जी की फिल्म के लिए ग्लोबल एडवर्टाइजर्स ने बहुत सपोर्ट किया है, इस पर आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
हाँ, जिन लोगों ने इनको सपोर्ट किया है उनको हम धन्यवाद देते हैं, और इसी तरह उनको सहायता बनी रहे ताकि ऐसी फिल्मों का प्रचार हो, और उनको हमारी तरफ से बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं और अभिनंदन और स्नेह और आदर.
ग्लोबल एडवर्टाइजर फॉर इनोवेटिव आउटडोर सॉल्यूशंस.